Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their 71st mission of the year with Starlink 7-4.
Go Falcon 9, go Starlink Group 7-4, go SpaceX.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1063, then landed successfully for the 14th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
We can still hopefully expect to see the Falcon Heavy launch tomorrow. The Psyche mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 12th at 2:16pm UTC or 10:16am EDT. We can also hopefully expect another couple of launches this week as well. The Starlink 622 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 12th at 10:55pm UTC or 6:55pm EDT. Then we can hopefully expect to see yet another Starlink mission launch soon as well. The Starlink 623 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 15th at 9:40pm UTC or 5:40pm EDT. SpaceX were planning back-to-back Starlink launches but had to postpone one of them. They said standing down from tonight's Falcon 9 launch attempt due to upper-level winds, teams are assessing the next available opportunity. In addition, they also posted teams are evaluating the next available opportunity for this Starlink launch. The upcoming NASA Psyche launch on Falcon Heavy has priority this week. Related to the Psyche launch, they also posted a picture with more info. They said Falcon Heavy went vertical overnight on Launch Complex 39 in Florida ahead of its launch of the Psyche mission to an interplanetary transfer orbit. There was an article posted related to Starlink and debris. It says SpaceX called on the Federal Aviation Administration to correct a report to Congress warning that by 2035 falling debris from US licensed constellations in low Earth orbit could injure or kill someone every 2 years if they deployed as planned. In an October 9th letter to the FAA and Congress seen by Space News, SpaceX principal engineer David Goldstein said the report relied on deeply flawed analysis based on assumptions, guesswork, and outdated studies. There was an article posted related to Falcon Heavy and NASA missions. It says you can consider this the start of NASA's Falcon Heavy era. The launch of the Psyche asteroid mission this week is the opening act among five launches the space agency has directly reserved on SpaceX's heavy lift rocket over the next 5 years. During the week, the pad was cleared so SpaceX could do some testing of Starship 26. Chris Bergin posted information about Ship 26 testing. He said Ship 26 middle right screen has a tanking test in the bag via Monday's activities, but today's testing window has been revoked. The next opportunity is Wednesday. Ship 26 is not expected to fly but should conduct events up to a static fire test. Ship 30 was seen moved outside briefly so ships could be moved around in the high bay. The hot staging ring has once again been removed from atop Booster 9. To finish up the video, we'll take a look at the closures on the Cameron County website. The closure on Monday concluded and the closure on Tuesday was revoked. There are a bunch of possible closures for this week though, and there was one for today, but that has been revoked. So the possible closures are for tomorrow, Thursday 12th, Friday 13th, and next week with Monday 16th. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.